There are two main theories of decision-making. The first is called heuristics and biases, and the name alone can tell you a lot about the decision-making just based on those terms. A heuristic is a kind of fast and sloppy way of making a decision, and a bias, of course, is a mistake or an error in your thinking. So heuristics and biases, in a nutshell, means that these researchers think that people aren't very good decision makers. Specifically, these researchers tend to think that there is an ideal way that we should be making decisions with an exact right or wrong answer, and they compare our decision making to that ideal standard. And as you might imagine, humans don't often measure up to that ideal standard, which leads the researchers to think that humans in general are not very good decision makers. So a classic example in psychology is if I ask you to imagine a room that has 70 lawyers but 30 engineers, and I tell you that I've chosen one person at random out of that room, and I give you a brief description, and I say that this person enjoys solving math problems, he enjoys doing puzzles, he enjoys building model ships, and I ask you to guess, is he a lawyer or is he an engineer? Most people will guess that he's an engineer because those kinds of hobbies sound like the sorts of things that an engineer would like to do. However, statistically speaking, it's much more likely that that person is a lawyer. So that's an example of the type of decision making we do that leads these heuristics and biases researchers to point to the mistakes we make and say, see, we're not very good decision makers. Because again, just based on the statistics, we should have said that that person that was chosen out of random from the room was a lawyer. The other way of thinking about decision making in psychology is from the perspective of bounded rationality. And where that term bounded comes from is these researchers recognize that our decision making is bounded or constrained or limited, and they say that's okay. Despite those constraints, we generally do pretty good decision making under those limits. And examples of limits might be things like maybe we don't have a lot of time, maybe we don't have a lot of memory or attention span at that moment, maybe we don't have a lot of background information to bear on the problem at hand. But again, the researchers say that instead of thinking of humans as being poor decision makers, we should focus on the fact that despite those constraints, we can be pretty good decision makers. And one example that they would give is, let's say that you're trying to make a decision about which city is larger, New Orleans versus Tallahassee. You may not have access to a computer at the moment to look up the exact population of those cities, so you could just draw a quick guess based on the fact that maybe you've heard of New Orleans more, or maybe you know that New Orleans has a professional football team, whereas Tallahassee doesn't. And so you could use whatever scraps of knowledge you do have under the limited time you do have to make that decision. And guess what? In that case, most people guess New Orleans is bigger, and of course they're right. And the researchers that follow this theory of bounded rationality point to lots of times when we make decisions in kind of what they call a fast and frugal manner, a quick and sloppy manner, and we end up making just fine decisions.
Vizi online texts are a new kind of textbook built with the help of great subject matter experts. These new learning resources have already helped thousands of students succeed. Our original content uses animations, simulations, video and graphics, self-assessments, exercises, and review materials to engage students in their study. Our approach is proven to improve learning outcomes. And that's why Vizi exists, to transform lives by making education more engaging.